Señoritas y señores, bienvenidos a otro video para la clase de español. Muchísimas gracias por acompañarme. Yes, I did promise in la clase de español, if you were in class today, that I would tell you about my horrible, terrible, no good weekend. Myself, my lovely wife, my baby twins, my mother-in-law, and her mother, who's about 84 years old. I think she's very elderly. We got hit by a drunk driver over the weekend, and it was a really scary, scary thing. Actually, my wife was at a conference. We went to San Diego for the weekend, and she was at a conference, and all of us, the rest of us, were in a rented minivan. And out of nowhere, here comes this car going about 35, 40 miles an hour, and there's a car behind us, thankfully, that acted as a buffer, but unfortunately, the driver of that car wore it pretty hard. He got severe whiplash and had to be taken to the hospital. And then his car hit ours. But it was a really, really scary experience. My baby twins started crying immediately because they were asleep in the back of the car. And to top it all off, and this is absolutely unbelievable, and this is way stupid. The driver of the vehicle that hit everybody got out of his car and ran. Now, I'm not really sure if you're aware of the severity of that. If you run away from a scene of a serious car, especially when there's injuries, yeah, you could be a convicted felon for doing something like that. Why did he run into the car behind us? I don't know. We're still waiting on the police report. And by the way, special shout out to San Diego PD. San Diego PD, you know, we're super, super duper helpful, and they put our family at ease, and they informed us that they apprehended this this suspect that was responsible for all this. Now we're just waiting for the full police report, and then of course all the fun, and you know, by fun I mean you know, paperwork having to do with like the insurance and liability and the contracts that we sign when renting the car and all of that. Now that has to be taken care of. But the most important thing is that my baby twins, my 11-month-old baby twins, are safe and they're okay. They got the bejesus scared out of them. I think all of us did, and they woke up screaming. And as a new daddy, you can imagine that I feared the worst. So I quickly got out of the car, made sure everyone's okay, and thank God everyone's okay. I'm just really hoping that the driver behind us, who I think was working for Lyft or Uber at the time, he was in bad shape, and so he got taken to the hospital. But I gotta just let you know out there, everybody. Listen, you're probably too young to drink, which is good. Don't drink, por favor. If you're under 21, follow the rules, por favor. But you probably have maybe older siblings, older cousins, older uncles. They probably have like you know, a drink here and there, and that's cool. That's totally legal. But in this day and age, I mentioned Uber and I mentioned Lyft. There is absolutely no reason to get behind the wheel when you've had one too many, all right? I've heard a lot about drunk driving and like the dangers of it, but now that I've been through an incident and my family's been through an incident where one was involved, now I think it's important to get the word out. Please, 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 if you know somebody who's had one too many and they're intent on driving, please do whatever you can to discourage that. Call them an Uber, call them a Lyft, call them a taxi, let them crash on your couch. You know, you're probably too young to drink if you're watching this, but you're not too young to step in and say, hey, listen, it's not a good decision for you to get behind the wheel. There's absolutely no excuse for it. There's absolutely no reason to get behind the wheel in 2018, especially with all of the options out there for you to get home safe. Yeah, thanks for listening, and thank God everyone's safe in my family, and definitely sending a lot of prayers and thoughts to the person who was behind us. Again, the full police report is pending, but it looks like yeah, it was a drunk driver that was involved or who caused all this. All right, so that being said, it's time for us to get back to la clase de español. Be safe out there, stay safe, and now let's get to the latest español lesson. Thanks for watching. Español 2, señoritas y señores, aquí les va el siguiente video. Estamos en el capítulo 6A. Miento, miento, I lie. Estamos
¿Dónde estamos?
Oh.
Ok, capítulo 5b. Lo siento. Ok, got a little twisted there. Chapter 5b. And so let's look up what you got to know. Capítulo 5b. Well, appropriately enough, un accidente. Señoritas y señores, sé que no nos gusta pensar en las cosas malas de la vida, pero no hay mucho que podemos hacer. Tenemos que enfrentar las cosas que no más o menos no nos gusta. Bueno, esto, por ejemplo, a mí no me gusta nada. Tener accidentes y tampoco ustedes, me imagino, ¿verdad? Chapter 5b. So, let's make this full screen. And muchísimas gracias, como siempre, por ver estos videos. Abran los libros a la página 288. Aquí vamos a estar para aprender el vocabulario nuevo. Para el capítulo 5b. Sí, hablando de los accidentes, hablando de a veces tenemos que ir al doctor, ver un médico, ver un doctor. Tenemos que contar a los demás cómo sucedieron las cosas, cómo pasó un accidente, por ejemplo. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, not the most pleasant round of vocabulary, but a fact of life, accidents will happen. And let's go through this whole thing here. Okay, let's talk about treatments for medical conditions. Como siempre, señoritas y señores, por favor, miren, escuchen, repitan, vengan. Vamos. Doler. Doler. Don't forget that doler in the present tense is a stem-changing verb where the O in the stem of that infinitive will change to a UE in most conjugations, except for nosotros, all right? Yo duelo, tú dueles, usted, él, ella duele, nosotros dolemos, no change. Ustedes, ellos, ellas duelen. El dolor. El dolor. El enfermero. La enfermera. Examinar. Examinar. La inyección. Las inyecciones. Poner una inyección. Poner una inyección. La medicina. La medicina. Las muletas. Las muletas. Las pastillas. Las pastillas. Las puntadas. Las puntadas. Dar puntadas. Dar puntadas. La radiografía. La radiografía. Sacar una radiografía. Sacar una radiografía. La receta. La receta. Recetar. Recetar. Roto. Rota. La sala de emergencia. La sala de emergencia. La sangre. La sangre. La silla de ruedas. La silla de ruedas. La venda. La venda. El yeso. el yeso. All right, those are all treatments for medical conditions. A lot of times in Spanish, you're going to have to explain how things happened using the preterite tense and imperfect tense, of course. Let's see some words that you would need to use. Not only verbs, but also nouns and adjectives and whatnot. Here we go. El accidente. El accidente. La ambulancia. La ambulancia. Caerse. Caerse. The se makes it reflexive. So, in the present tense, me caigo. Irregular, don't forget. Te caes. Se cayó. Usted, él, ella, se cayó. Notice the spelling change right over here. En caer. Se cayeron. Ustedes, ellos, ellas se cayeron. Again, spelling change. Chocar con. Chocar con. Cortarse. Cortarse. Lastimarse. Lastimarse. ¿Qué te pasó? ¿Qué te pasó? Romperse. Romperse. Torcerse. Torcerse. Tropezar con. Tropezar con. Okay, so watch out for torcerse in the present tense. It is stem changing. Same with tropezar. That is stem changing as well. You can see where the root or the stem was originally here. And then it's spelling change right over here. I should probably let you know that romper means to break. But it's very common to also say quebrar. Quebrar. Okay, so romperse, quebrarse. La mano. You know, for one to somebody to break their hand. Okay, parts of the body. El codo. El codo. El cuello. El cuello. La espalda. La espalda. El hombro. El hombro. El hueso. El hueso. La muñeca. La muñeca. All right, so in previous chapters that meant a doll, like a toy doll, but in this context it means your wrist. El músculo. El músculo. La rodilla. La rodilla. El tobillo. El tobillo. And then finally, other useful words and expressions. Moverse. Moverse. Once again, a stem changing verb, but then also reflexive with the se part at the end. Stem changing in the present tense, I should say. Pobrecito. Pobrecita. Poor thing. Qué lástima. Qué lástima. And then finally, sentirse. Sentirse. All right, so the set part makes it reflexive, and then of course present tense would be the I in sentir, sentirse, and then it changes into an IE in most cases, except nosotros, like we learned. And then the next video, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be revisiting once again the preterite tense more in detail. You're going to have some irregular preterite conjugations. Son muy difíciles. Once again, preterite conjugations are no joke. They do require time, care, attention, and I hope you're doing just that. If you forgot how to conjugate your preterite verbs up to this point in the school year, there's no shame in going back and watching previous videos about how to do them, okay? Look at all these. Look at all these crazy conjugations, okay? There's no formula. You just have to memorize them, especially with verbs such as decir, traer, poner, and then, oh, look at this. We're going to be learning something called the imperfect progressive, and we're going to be examining present participles, you know. I think we already talked about what you're doing right now. We're going to be revisiting that as well. So lots of Espanol goodness, señoritas y señores, to do before the school year lets out. Como siempre, señoritas y señores, muchísimas gracias por ver estos videos. Dejen un comentario abajo para los puntos si estás en la clase de español conmigo, señor Barbosa. And that's it. That's it. That's going to do it for today. Thanks very much for watching. And to get the word out once again, ladies and gentlemen, drunk driving is not cool. And don't do it. Spread the word. Thanks. I'll see you next time.